Hi, I'm Dr. Gary Namie, and I'm inviting you to participate in Freedom from Workplace Bullies Week. Yes, it's an event that we have been calling annually for the last several years, since I think 2009, and we want everyone in the country to participate. And by that, by participate, what I mean is take this opportunity to break the silence about this scourge of our American workplace. You know, 35% of the U.S. workforce has been bullied. That's 54 million Americans. It's an epidemic, but we don't talk about it nearly enough because partly the shame involved and partly because employers don't want you to talk about it. They'd like to bury the story. It's a source of shame even for them. So what we need to do is take this week as an opportunity to break that silence. And I want each and every one of you to do something. Let's talk about education. We have a trained group of state coordinators who are working to enact the anti-bullying law, healthy workplace bill, in nearly every state. We have coordinators at this time in 38 states. Those folks can go and speak. We have a trained force of alums from the Workplace Bullying University who are experts in workplace bullying and are affiliates of the Workplace Bullying Institute. We will be listing the cities in which these people live so you can have access to getting a talk, a community talk, or an on-site at your workplace talk from a bona fide expert. We plan some national events and some local events. We're actually located here in the state of Washington. The second kind of participation we'd like is for organizations who endorse our work. Just endorse our work, which is an anti-abuse campaign in the American workplace. A statement that we are fed up with these campaigns of systematic destruction that bullies engage in, and that these abusers on the payroll have no right to continue to operate with impunity. Any organization that endorses that statement, we welcome you. And by the same token, an extension, several city governments and county governments and states have then proclaimed Freedom from Workplace Bullies Week. And we invite your city council or county council or state and governor to do the same. So we seek all the proclamations and we post them at the Workplace Bullying Institute website. And finally, the third part of the Freedom Week activity we'd like to see is that bullied targets, we don't call them victims, you bullied targets actually do something to personally empower yourself this week. No, we're not going to tell you to go report the problem to HR or go to confront your bully. That's silly. If you would have, you could have. But what we want you to do is maybe break the silence at home. Tell your family. There's no shame in this bullying. You didn't ask for it. You're certainly not alone and you certainly didn't cause it. It's an unwanted, uninvited, pretentious, unconscionable assault. So the bully's been in control of your life. Take back some control during this week. Make a statement for yourself. It'll feel good. Tell somebody. Tell a loved one. Tell a family member. Tell someone where you can be safe. But for God's sakes, break the silence without a doubt. Now, we also have a special plea to mental health professionals to learn about workplace bullying. You can desperately hurt, terribly hurt people if you're unaware of the powers of the workplace environment over otherwise good workers. It's not the worker who's to blame that's come to see you with a bullying complaint. Remember that. Don't commit the fundamental attribution error. Dear employers, why don't you look at your bottom line? These bullies are dreadfully expensive. Bullies are, in fact, too expensive to keep. Why don't you take a look at what money you could save and what morale you could boost and what loyalty you could engender if you would simply decide to systemically attack workplace bullying instead of dealing with it on a case-by-case basis. School administrators, you need to pay attention to what's happening in bullying, but not just with the students. What about the adult-on-adult bullying, those who are modeling bullying for the kids? It's never going to be eradicated in your school when it is system-wide, and it's system-wide unless and until you address it with the adults. Now, I have a special message to you coworkers out there, coworkers who have witnessed this bullying. I know it's upset you, and for some people, it even is traumatizing. But you know the way out of that pain and the guilt of not doing anything? You got it. Do something. Do something in force. Do something as a collective. Gather together. Confront the bully as a group. Then you're all safe. They can't fire all of you. not at all at one time. For gosh sakes, there's power in numbers. Stop cowering behind your own fear and try and support that friend of yours, that colleague, who is suffering terribly. Co-workers, you hold the key to nipping this in the bud. So, please, during Freedom Week, do something. The message is do something. Work shouldn't hurt.